Hello, I'll start when they're looking for my slides. Great, thanks for this opportunity to present. To be honest, our modest experience in irradiating stereotoxic irradiation of the brain in neuroblastoma patients is actually one clinical case, but to my opinion and to the opinion of our pediatric oncologists, it may be of interest to this audience. Overall incidence of metastasis in the brain in neuroblastomas, relapses, based on various authors, fluctuates within a very wide range. Some people think that it is a very rare thing. The other authors say that there may be up to 10% of relapses. But all of them say that with the growth of survival of high-risk group of such patients, the incidence of CNS involvement will increase during recurrences in such patients. Risk factors, based on some authors' opinion, is younger age at the moment of primary diagnostic, involvement of bone marrow at primary diagnosis, and unfortunately, the survival of such patients in the majority of publications is not very high. Other authors from China speak about the incidence of metastasis in the brain during recurrences of high-risk neuroblastoma amounted to almost 6%, and the survival, 2-year survival, to 82%, but this survival was not from the moment of the relapse, but from the moment of primary diagnostics. Hence, this figure is closer to the truth, I think. On the whole, the same as the previous presenter, radiotherapy. We do not have ready answers in radiotherapy, either in primary therapy of neuroblastoma, to say nothing about relapses. Brain relapses or brain metastases are treated with various methods and their combinations. In the majority of the studies, the effects were not very good, and most of the authors stress the complete surgical resection. The best result out of what I've managed to find in patients with metastasis in the brain, such an aggressive protocol of therapy, starting with resection and Amaya catheter installment, craniospinal irradiation, chemotherapy, intrathecal radioimmunotherapy, with further chemotherapy, and overall duration of therapy was up to 2 years. But in this group, these were the best of results once again, and the median of survival was 33 months. As for SABR, there's a very short experience of using SABR in primary brain neuroblastoma, and only 2 cases where radiosurgery was used. In both cases, gamma knife was used, and the doses were 27.7 and 14 grays, respectively. Overall, this was a radiosurgical intervention. One of the patients lived for 15 months after that and died from the progression, but no progression in the CNS. The second patient had an objective response, but after 4 months, there was CNS relapse, and the patient died quite quickly. And now our clinical case. We had a patient who was 20 months by the moment of primary diagnostics. Based on all criteria, he was allocated to the high-risk zone, bone marrow involvement, skull bones involvement. massive tumor in the adrenal gland, MINC amplification. He received his treatment with 3 courses of induction therapy, peripheral stem cells preparation. As a local control, he received adrenalectomy. The tumor was preserved, but the intervention was radical. High dose polychemotherapy, but then a brain metastasis was developed. He was examined and there were no other foci found. Second line therapy was decided as a radiosurgery treatment. We had Navalis at our disposal. The doses were standard doses used in wrist with metastasis into the brain. The metastatic focus was 2.5 centimeters. Everything was very well planned. A line CT MRI, and that's how the focus looked like. With better counters, we used MRT, a technique with with different fields, and we had very good comfort index with and a good distribution. The boy was fixed in the thermoplastic mask, non-invasive. No invasive fixation. The therapy is carried out under X-ray control with robotized table use. After 2 months, the focus regressed by 50%. Chemotherapy with dinutuximab was used, but after 2 courses, anemia developed. He was withdrawn from this therapy and is treated with retinal acid. There's a how the focus looked like initially after 8 months and what we have now. The patient is in the state of clinical remission and he is almost 5 years old. It seems to me that on the background of the overall pessimistic picture, this case deserves some attention. Thank you.